Hi everyone, and welcome to another Kingdom Quest. We're so glad to have you with us this morning. My name is Pastor Josh.
I'm Catherine.
And it's a great day to be here, to be singing and hearing about the love of God. And that's what we're going to talk about today. God loves all of us so very much, and that includes you. God loves you. And that's our big discussion for today. Well, let's sing about it. Here we go. I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the Lord.
Who is worthy to be praised.
Who is worthy to be praised.
So shall I be saved from my enemies. The Lord liveth,
and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
Say what?
The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
Boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, boom.
Kick it!
I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the Lord.
Who is worthy to be praised?
Who is worthy to be praised?
So shall I be saved from my enemies.
So shall I be saved from my enemies.
The Lord liveth,
and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
What the Lord liveth,
and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
Boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, boom. Okay, yeah! I will call upon the Lord.
I will call upon the Lord.
Who is worthy to be praised.
God of our salvation be exalted.
Say what? The Lord liveth,
and blessed be the rock, and may the God of our salvation be exalted.
Boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, chicka, chicka, boom, boom, boom.
Okay, get it!
Woo! All right. Hey, you guys know this song. We're going to sing Bullfrogs and Butterflies. You remember this one? Get your butterflies out. Woo!
Bullfrogs and butterflies, we've both been born again. Bullfrogs and butterflies, they both been born again. But bullfrogs and butterflies, they both been born again. Bullfrogs and butterflies, they both been born again. Old tadpole in a fishing hole, he couldn't croak or jump to save his soul. But then one day it was the funniest thing. He started growing and turning green. Well, he jumped up on a lily pad. He's croaking out a song, giving all he had. He's singing, bullfrogs and butterflies, they've both been born again. Bullfrogs and butterflies, we've both been born again. Bullfrogs and butterflies, they've both been born again. Bullfrogs and butterflies, they've both been born again. Little caterpillar on a blade of grass, she's noticing the day going by so fast. She's a lovely little lady, and she's looking for a room. She's leaving and she's spinning out a fine cocoon. Well, it didn't take long till she saw the sky.
Spread your wings, you're a butterfly. She's singing,
bullfrogs and butterflies, they both been born again. 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 All right. So today is an exciting day because we have reached the day where our story matches our song of the month. So, it's fine. I broke it, but it's fine. So I'm gonna fix it. Never a dull moment around here, kids. All right. So, you ready? Let's test your memory. Let the little children come to me. Matthew 19:14. Let the little children come to me. Matthew 19:14. Ready? Let the little children come to me. Matthew 19:14. Let the little children come to me. Matthew 19:14. And today is the day that we get to learn about where that is in the Bible. I'm going to pick this up from the bottom. All right. The friend of little children. Jesus' friends were arguing. Who was the most important helper to Jesus? Who was the most important helper in God's kingdom? They wanted to know. I am, James said. No, you're not, said Peter. I am. Nonsense, Matthew said. I'm the smartest. No, you're not. Yes, I am. Yes, no, it's me. Me too. What? This silliness went on and on like that for a while. You see, Jesus' friends had started thinking that they had to do something to make themselves special to Jesus. That if they were the smartest, or the nicest, or the best at running, or the best at speaking, they would be the most important, and Jesus would like them the best. But they had forgotten something. Something God had been teaching his people all through the years. That no matter how smart you are, or how good you are, or how rich you are, or how nice you are, or how important you are, none of it makes any difference. Because God's love is a gift. And as anyone will tell you, the whole thing about a gift is that it's free. All you have to do is reach out your hands. So while Jesus' friends were arguing, some people who knew all about getting gifts, in fact, you might say they were gift-getting experts, had come to see Jesus. Who were they? They were little children. Jesus' helpers tried to shoo them away and get them to leave Jesus alone. Jesus doesn't have time for you, they told them. He's too tired. But they were wrong. Jesus always had time for children. Don't ever send them away, Jesus said. Bring them to me. Now, if you had been there, what do you think you would have seen? Would you have had to line up quietly to see Jesus? Do you think Jesus would have asked you how good you'd been before he gave you a hug? Would you have had to be on your best behavior, get all fancy and dressed up, and not speak until you're spoken to? Or would you have done just what these children did? Run straight up to Jesus and let him pick you up in his arms, swing you around, kiss you, hug you, then sit you on his lap and listen to your stories and what you have to say? You see, the children loved Jesus, and they knew that they didn't need to do anything special for Jesus to love them.
All they needed to do was to run into his arms. And that is exactly what they did. After all the laughing and games, Jesus turned to his helpers and said, "No matter how big you grow, never grow up so much that you lose your child's heart, full of trust in God. Be like these children. They are the most important in my kingdom." So this story talks about kids, but talks about adults too. So in the beginning, there were the people who were arguing, and they were talking about who was the most important, who had done the best things for Jesus to love them the most. But they had it all wrong. The kids knew that that didn't matter. Jesus loved them no matter what. Jesus wanted to be with them. Jesus wanted to spend time with them because he loves them. They didn't have to do anything special. They didn't have to be the best at running. They didn't have to be the nicest person. They didn't have to have the fanciest clothes. They just had to be themselves. And Jesus loved them for who they were. Jesus loves all of us, no matter what. That's what's important in this story, is that no matter what, Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you if you are really nice. Jesus loves you on days that maybe you're not nice at all. Jesus loves you if you're the best runner. Jesus loves you if you're the worst runner, like me. Jesus loves you if you're really good at math. Jesus loves you if you're really bad at reading. Jesus loves you no matter what. He says, "Let the little children come to me." We can always go to him because he loves us. We can always talk to him when we pray. We can always ask him for help. No matter what, he never leaves us because Jesus always takes care of us, no matter what. And the most amazing thing that he did to take care of us is to die on that cross. That cross is big. It was scary. It was not fun. It was sad, and it hurt. But he stayed there anyway because he loves you that much. He didn't care that it was sad or scary. He knew that he wanted to save you because he loves you. And so he stayed there for you. And because he did that for you, we get to tell everybody that he did that for us too. Because there are some people who don't know that yet. We get to tell everybody that no matter what, no matter how we feel, no matter if we think we're amazing, if we don't feel very good about ourselves, Jesus loves us no matter what. And that's what's important in this story. Don't ever forget that no matter what, no matter what at all, Jesus loves you. Can you pray with me? Dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For always loving me.
For always loving me.
No matter what.
No matter what.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For always taking care of me.
For always taking care of me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For saving me.
For saving me.
On the cross.
On the cross.
We love you.
We love you.
In your name we pray.
In your name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
So our last song is very fitting. It's Jesus Loves Me. And no matter what, this song is never going to get old because everything in here is true. No matter what, he always loves us.
Jesus loves me. Thank you.
Well, thank you, boys and girls. We're so glad that you joined us. Everybody have a wonderful day. We'll see you later.
Bye. Bye.